Signing out, ES News, Ande Emilio, and why?
Talk to me for a second, bro. New York City, big fights. What's going on, man?
You know, just here for the press conference, getting ready for Saturday.
You know, tell everybody you know about this fight that you know they're going to have on Saturday. And what can we expect? You know, you're a real flickster style. You know,
it's an interesting fight, man. I'm just going out there and make it look easy. I want to make it look easy as possible, get the victory, and move on to the next.
Everybody's seen the beef with you and Tank on Instagram, you know.
Yeah.
What's going on? We'll ever see you two guys in an actual, you know, real fight? I know he was calling you out for sparring or whatever.
I don't know. I would like that, but right now, focus on Saturday. After that, then we'll see what happens. I doubt if it happened, but, you know, it may happen.
What do you know about your opponent Saturday?
Nothing. Then he just comes forward. That's it.
Are you the kind of guy who watches tape, or do you adjust?
I don't watch tape, but for this fight, I did watch it once or twice. Regular guy, regular fighter, straight up and down fighter, nothing special.
Now, everyone knows you as a fighter who started off with kind of a losing streak for a second, and now you're back on it. A lot of people are saying, you know, you're one of the best out there. Yeah. You know, who are some of the fighters you look to that kind of, you know, molded your style?
I mean,
not even like a Floyd Mayweather, because people say there's comparisons.
Honestly, God, I was never into boxing. I started boxing when I was 19.
Okay.
I'm only 25.
So how'd you get that great, incredible slickster style with the bobbing and weaving, shoulder?
Yeah, it's just natural, man. And, you know, working on my craft, just getting better, just wanting to do better for myself. And the losses that I took, I just got into boxing. I was doing boxing as a hobby. It wasn't a profession to me. It was a hobby. Now, this is my career. I took it to another level. I changed my team. I changed everything, my eating habits, my work ethic, and I'm here today.
Out of all your losses, which one would you like to avenge most?
Well, I would say all of them, but the guys that beat me, most of them, I passed them.
Okay.
Pedraza, definitely Pedraza,
right?
Yeah. Yeah. I took that fight with a 3-day notice, and I still made it to 8.
What do you feel you have to do to get that rematch?
It's not up to me. It's up to Lou, my promoter, or it's up to whoever. It ain't up to me. The only thing I can do is say I want the fight. That's it.
Mm.
Other than that, I don't know what to do. What to say?
What do you think about, you know, the current state of boxing? You know, it's in flux. You know, Terrence Crawford has had a big win.
Yeah.
A lot of people's, you know, pound for pound lists are changing every week because all these big wins. Who's Tevin Farmer's pound for pound list right now?
Top five?
Yeah.
Top five, Floyd is out, so he's retired. No order. I would probably have to say Lomachenko, Crawford, War, Kovalov, and probably Canelo. That's just off this thinking on top. I don't know. That's just thinking on top.
You and Lomachenko are close in weight.
Yeah. We spar plenty of times. Yeah.
How was that sparring?
It was hella sparring, I'll tell you that.
Yeah.
When I got in there with him, I knew that he was on another level than everybody else that I sparred. I sparred a lot of people. And if you ask me, he'd be like, yo, Tevin Farmer was probably one of my best sparring partners I've ever had.
Mm. So is he head and shoulders above everybody else in that weight class?
Absolutely. Yep. Besides myself, he's the best in the weight class. I gotta say it honestly.
You know, people are saying Andre Berto, Danny Garcia.
Yeah.
What do you think about that fight if it happens?
Easy work for Danny Garcia. I like Berto, but yeah. I'm not being biased. I don't know. It depends. I'm not being biased, but Danny just, he proved to me that no matter how many people doubt him, he always come and step up and get the win, get the victories. No matter what happened, he get the victory. He pull him out. Some way or what, he pull him out.
What do you think about, you know, it's really supposed, but Danny Garcia and Adrian Broner supposedly turned down $4 million to fight Manny Pacquiao.
Say that one more time.
Supposedly, Garcia and Broner both turned down a Pacquiao fight for $4 million. What do you think about that?
That's their business. Mm-hmm. Obviously, they feel as though it's not worth it, or they want more money, or whatever the case may be. It's their business, man. And if they don't want to take $4 million, a lot of people say, oh, I would have took it. What if you would have took it? That's what you think. You may need the money more than they do, or you may want to take it for a different reason, for pride. Whatever them dudes wanted to do, that's on them, man.
What do you think about Crawford Pacquiao?
Oh man, that's a good one, man. That's a good one. Pacquiao on his way out, but still got some steam in him. Crawford on his way up. And right now, when you got a young guy on his way up, that confidence, that's something you can't take away from a person, man. When a person got confidence and they believe in their ability, they could do a lot of damage. So that's an upper grand fight. If I had wanting one of them to win, I would say Crawford. I want Crawford to win if they fall, but I don't know who will win.
Can anybody bring Floyd out of retirement? Is there anybody out there who's
only him
bringing that name?
Only him. Mm-hmm. Only him. No money can do it. No fighter can do it. Only he can do it if he wants to. That's only if he misses boxing.
Last but not least, man, tell everybody where they can find you at.
Tevin Farmer, 22.
Right there,
Tevin Farmer, 22.